Now, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First for the Titans of Illinois Wesleyan. 5'9", senior number 5, Elliot Gonzalez. 6'5", senior number 25, Jordan Zimmer. 6'5", sophomore number 32, Victor Davis. 6'6", senior number 34, John Kajnitsky. And 6'7", junior number 50, Kevin Reed. The Titans are coached by Ron Rose and enter tonight's game with an overall record of 13-3. And now, the starting lineup for your Elmhurst College Blue Jays. 5'11" junior number 1, Deontay Foster. 6'3" junior number 5, James Robertson. 6'6" senior number 23, Jerome Robinson. 6'3" senior number 24, Zach Boyd. And 6'4" sophomore number 25, Nick Sanford. The Blue Jays are coached by Mark Scherer, assisted by Chris Martin and Nick Michael. Elmhurst enters tonight's contest with an overall record of 9-7.
And what a fine introduction here at R.A. Fagatel Hall. Good evening, everyone. I'm Tim Calderwood with you for game 2 of a doubleheader. Elmhurst College preparing to take on Illinois Wesleyan University. This is the men's matchup. Illinois Wesleyan ranks 17th in the D3Hoops.com Top 25 poll. 1 week ago tonight, Elmhurst upset nationally ranked Augustana on a buzzer beater from Zach Boyd. Can they repeat the feat here at home tonight? Another great crowd is on hand. Elmhurst just a game behind Illinois Wesleyan in the CCIW race. The Titans are 4-1, and the Blue Jays are 3-2. Again, Tim Calderwood with you from R.A. Fagatel Hall on the campus of Elmhurst College tonight for the CCIW men's basketball matchup between Elmhurst and Illinois Wesleyan. Big thanks to Bruce Hill for introducing the starting lineups for you. Nice to have those. We'll recap them for you. Elmhurst, Deontay Foster, James Robertson, Jerome Robinson, Zach Boyd, and Nick Sanford. Illinois Wesleyan, Elliot Gonzalez, Jordan Zimmer, Victor Davis, John Kajnitsky, and Kevin Reed. Mark Scheer, the head coach of the Blue Jays, who are 9-7, 3-2 in the CCIW. Ron Rose, the head coach at Illinois Wesleyan, 13-3, 4-1 in the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin. We're underway. Illinois Wesleyan in the green controls the tip. Titans tied atop the CCIW standings with two other teams sitting 4-1. Big, big home matchup for the Blue Jays, who force a quick turnover. Zach Boyd turns on the Jets, eases it ahead towards the corner, rolling towards the elbow, up high Sanford, back out Foster. First trip up the floor for Elmhurst in the whites. Boyd angles left, picks it up, out comes Robinson. 15 to work with for Deontay Foster. Here's Robertson off a screen, high right, money! James Robertson, it's a three-pointer. Quickly ahead, though, Illinois Wesleyan. Kajnitsky to the rack, no. Second chance coming, loose ball, knocked away. Robinson couldn't bring it in, and he is slammed down to the floor. A couple of Elmhurst fans, so kind to usher Robinson back to his feet. Charge the foul to Jordan Zimmer, his first of the evening as well. Elmhurst up 3-0, closing in on the first minute of this one. Illinois Wesleyan, Wheaton, and North Central, all 4-1 in the CCIW. Elmhurst 3-2, Augustana, Carthage 2-3, North Park 1-4, Milliken winless at 0-5. Foster off a screen for three, bingo! Back-to-back threes for the Blue Jays, who have opened an early 6-0 advantage here at home. Good denial by Jerome Robinson. Gonzalez takes his time, locates Kajnitsky at the elbow, Now it's Davis. He'll put it on the deck. Drive, lean in. Offensive foul. Wave it off. Nick Sanford held his ground underneath the basket to draw the charge. Foul is on Davis. His first team foul, number two. Other games in the CCIW tonight. North Central at Millikan. Carthage at Augustana. Earlier this afternoon, it was Wheaton taking care of North Park in Chicago. 75-52. Hope you're safe. Made it through the weather yesterday. Boy, that was some kind of storm. I had quite the fiasco. Spending 5 hours in my car trying to drive yesterday. But I'm here with you now, which is all that matters. Robinson will drive. Denied shy of the free throw line. Shot is at 10. Entry pass towards Sanford. Looks for Robinson, who will get it back. Jump ball is called. Possession stays with Elmhurst. 5 on the shot. Shot clock inadvertent reset. It was at 5 seconds, and the officials will talk it over. Dave Lanning, Robert Dowling, Dave King, the officials as assigned by the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin tonight. Perhaps the biggest thing to keep your eye on in this one, rebounding. Two of the top rebounding teams in the conference. Illinois Wesleyan second, Elmhurst third. Backing up to the victory over Augustana last week, the biggest key for Elmhurst was the glass. A win for the Blue Jays tonight would mark the first time that Elmhurst has been able to win 3 consecutive CCIW contests since the 2008-2009 campaign. It was the last time Elmhurst reached the NCAA tournament as well. They won 7 consecutive conference games. And they will indeed put 5 up on the shot clock. Elmhurst has a little time to work with here, but look for a lob into the lane perhaps for Robinson. Now Ron Rose trying to direct his defense. Referee will back up. Elliot Gonzalez on Foster. Robertson, the trigger man, to Foster in the corner. Foster in the baseline. Has to throw it up to beat the shot clock. Doesn't touch anything. It's a violation. Elmhurst took care of Millikan on the road earlier this week, Tuesday night, 71-49. Three-pointer 14 seconds into the ball game, handed Elmhurst the lead. They led by as many as 25 and never trailing on their way to the victory. Strong to the rack is Reed, scooping and scoring. First points for Illinois Wesleyan in the matchup. And a warning issued by the officiating crew. Ironic, given that 14 seconds into the ball game on Tuesday, Elmhurst took the advantage of the three. They've hit 2 threes today and have never trailed up 6-2 as we come up on 2.5 minutes into the matchup. Sanford, though, will throw it away. Illinois Wesleyan, meanwhile, suffered its first loss in the CCIW on Tuesday earlier this week, falling 82-69. Titans shot just 39% at North Central. Elliot Gonzalez with 15 points. John Kashnitsky, 11 in the defeat. Davis with 1 dribble. Continue to move it around the arc. Davis in the corner for 3. Off the mark. It's long, but Gonzalez a strong rebound. Nobody closed out for Elmhurst. Provide the Titans with more offense. Here's Davis. He takes advantage in the lane. 4 straight for Illinois Wesleyan after 6 straight from Elmhurst to start. The Titans will put on a little obligatory press. Elmhurst having some problems momentarily. Foster has to hurry his way across the timeline. Gonzalez and Robinson tangle. Boyd wants to lob and a foul. Offensive against Deontay Foster. Meeting number 118 between Elmhurst and Illinois Wesleyan in men's basketball. Illinois Wesleyan has been dominant. 4 consecutive wins. Last victory for Elmhurst came during that 2008-2009 season we spoke of. Reed drives in. Too strong. Came over the top looking for the rebound, but Sanford was able to bring it in. 95-22, the all-time advantage for Illinois Wesleyan. And a blocking foul. Look out, it's the second on Jordan Zimmer. Leading scorer for Illinois Wesleyan, Jordan Zimmer out of Delavan, Illinois. 15.2 points per ball game, third in the conference. Heads to the bench, not only 4 minutes into the contest. Brandon Grubel, Justin Phipps on the hardwood for the Blue Jays. First off the bench for Illinois Wesleyan, Steven Rudnicki. Grubel in the corner with Rudnicki on him defensively. Looking to lob for Robinson. Beautiful finish. The feed from Phipps led Robinson right to the basket for the bucket. 8-4, Elmhurst doubling up Illinois Wesleyan. Here's Davis, fakes left, moves right in the lane. It won't fall, but free throws coming. Illinois Wesleyan, a 68% team from the line this year, fifth in the CCIW. Davis specifically at 67%, 29 of 43, but he's solid here on attempt number one. Davis, just a sophomore. Tied with Kevin Reed for second on the team in scoring at 10 a ball game. He's out of Galesburg. 8-6 as he connects on both free throws. Earlier tonight, the Illinois Wesleyan women had no problem with Elmhurst. A matchup of the only two unbeaten teams in the CCIW was a 19-point win for Illinois Wesleyan on the road. Boyd misses the running hook shot. It's an air ball. Rudnicki will start the breakout. Davis open 4-3 and the lead off to the right. Away comes Boyd. Koshnitsky on him. Boyd trying to win the battle. Grubel looking back door and Gonzalez read it all the way. 2-on-2. Gonzalez will ease it ahead. 8-6 Elmhurst lead. Reed sets a screen. Rudnicki leans in from 13, in and out. Rebound to Foster. Timeout Elmhurst. A 30-second timeout. North Central and Milliken have reached halftime. North Central on top of the Big Blue, 31-23 down in Decatur. I'm Tim Calderwood with you here on Blue Jay TV on this Saturday evening. Glad to have you alongside. It's been an entertaining start. Elmhurst hit consecutive three-pointers to open the ball game. James Robertson and Deontay Foster handed the Blue Jays an early 6-0 advantage. From that point on, though, Elmhurst has been limited to but 2 points. As we've talked about early, this one could come down to the battle of the boards, and it has certainly been competitive on the glass early here in the opening 20 minutes of play. Mark Scheer spending a timeout, trying to calm his team down 5 minutes in. If you're just joining us, Jordan Zimmer already with two fouls. Eric Dornfeld in for Elmhurst off the bench. Nick Anderson has emerged for Illinois Wesleyan along with Andrew Zimnik. Foster Chinkhorst signaling the play. Head up. Grubel above his head and an offensive foul away from the basketball. Jerome Robinson with his first. Team foul number three, 14:36 first half. 8-6 Elmhurst on top. Victory in the house. I see him underneath the basket. Elmhurst played zone against Augustana. They come out zone here against the Titans as well. This is a little bit of a different look though. 2-1-2. Gonzalez for three, in and out. Boyd came swooping in for the rebound, and it's knocked out of bounds off of Zimnik. Blue Jay basketball with 14:10 to play in the half. Elmhurst has hit on three of its first 6 shots in this one, including 2 of 2 from the land of three. Illinois Wesleyan just 2 of 7 to open the matchup here tonight. Elmhurst does own the early advantage on the glass. Here's Robinson, isolated on the left side, clearing out. Grubel tries to drive, looking to gain separation. Foster head up, shot clock inside of 10. Foster flips to Boyd, his three-pointer is blocked. Boyd follows it up to beat the buzzer, no. Underneath, it's free. Dornfeld held up, a whistle coming. Is it on Illinois Wesleyan? It is. Much to the dismay of Ron Rose. Charge it to Eric Dortch, his first. Zach Boyd moments ago following the shot off of the miss. It's one of the reasons why Elmhurst has been so good on the glass this year. They seem to know and be able to sense when their shots are off and never give up. Follow suit and take the right positions to try to get second and third chances. Sanford strong to the basket, can't score. Little too much as it's short off the front of the rim. Rudnicki comes away for the Titans. Zimnik, three-pointer in and out. Sanford the board. 7 minutes into the half. Grubel knifing baseline. Tapped away. Elmhurst saves the possession. But Grubel wasn't ready. It's out of his reach and into the front row of seats. And again, a very good crowd assembled here at R.A. Fagetal Hall for this one. Big home game for the Blue Jays. They find themselves right in the middle of not only the CCIW tournament race, but for that matter, the CCIW championship race. Top six teams separated by only two games. The top four will make the championship tournament hosted by the top seed late in February. Skipped into the post, offensive foul. Anderson runs over the top of Sanford. It's a very underappreciated element of Nick Sanford's game. His ability to draw charges in the post, that is two today that Sanford has been able to draw. Remains an 8-6 edge for Elmhurst. Grubel towards the corner. Here comes Robertson in the triple threat, wanted to shoot. Koshnitsky on him defensively. Illinois Wesleyan in the man. Titans do have a lot of size, which is why I compared them a little bit to that matchup against Illinois or against Augustana last week. Shot clock under 10. Grubel down Main Street. Switches hands, adjusts his shot, uses the glass to convert. 10-6, first points in a while. Dortch pulls up along the baseline. His floating 10-footer won't go. Robertson chases down. Assistant coach Chris Martin lost some of his paperwork in the exchange moments ago. And an offensive foul away from the basketball on Dornfeld. First on Dornfeld. Fourth on Elmhurst. Timeout. Illinois Wesleyan with a 30-second timeout. The Titans trailing Elmhurst 10-6 in the early goings of this one. 11:33 to play in the first half. I'm Tim Calderwood with you on the campus of Elmhurst College for the CCIW men's basketball matchup. Not surprisingly, Elmhurst doing a very solid job defensively here in the early goings of the contest. Illinois Wesleyan just 2 of 9 from the field. One of the reasons for that, the Blue Jays do a great job of clogging the lane. They don't necessarily have the biggest size in the post, but sometimes when you can have 2 and 3 players collapsing consistently, it can make things hard to come by. And Illinois Wesleyan has not been able to hit the jump shots here early in the matchup either. Elmhurst up 4-10-6 with 11:33 to play in the first. Taking a look down the road for Elmhurst. They will officially wrap up the first go-round through the CCIW on Tuesday at Carthage. 7:30 matchup in Kenosha. And they'll be at North Park next Saturday. The ball is right through the legs of Reed and into the waiting arms of Dornfeld. Next home game for the Blue Jays comes up Tuesday, January 31st against North Central. We'll have it for you here on Blue Jay TV. Sanford tried to lob, partially deflected by Davis. Here's Dortch pulling up and easing out the offense. 4-point Elmhurst lead. Reed, free throw line extended to the corner for Dortch. He looks to drive. Davis is surrounded, and there's Robertson with his arms in the air. How many times do you hear about coaches consistently telling players on defense, keep your arms up? Why? Because you can easily come up with deflections and steals. Robertson will curl off a screen. And now we'll cross over and flip it back to Brandon Grubel as Elmhurst resets with the play call for Mark Scheer. Boyd angling right, double team. Sanford sets the screen. Koshnitsky tries to come underneath. Boyd in the lane scores. First points of the ball game for Zach Boyd. He's the leading scorer for Elmhurst at just under 15 a night. Boyd racked up 14 points and 10 rebounds in the victory over Milliken on Tuesday. Dortch, jump stop, powerful move, scores. Past the midway point of the contest, a four-point advantage for Elmhurst. Illinois Wesleyan is 0-4 from three-point range. Boyd utilizes the screen from Sanford. Now Dornfeld will set one. Boyd dead on from 17 off the back iron. Davis chases down the board on the weak side. Away comes Boyd off to the races. Boyd ahead in transition. Counted and a foul. Victor Davis was a little slow getting back on defense. Did his best to force Boyd to change the shot. Now Davis with two fouls. So you're looking at two of the top three scorers for Illinois Wesleyan in foul trouble with 9:22 to play in the half. Zimmer and Davis with two apiece. Zimmer, in fact, will re-enter. Parker Musselman, a 6'8 freshman center, is on the hardwood. Elliot Gonzalez back for the Titans as well. Boyd trying to finish the three-point play. It's up and good. Seven-point lead is the largest of the contest for Elmhurst. 15-8. Timeout, Elmhurst. It's a full one, and we break. 9:22 to play in the first half. Elmhurst up 15-8. This is Blue Jay TV. Wesleyan inbounding the basketball with 9:18 to play in the half, down seven. It's the largest lead of the half for Elmhurst, who scored the first 6 points of the ball game. Zimmer for three off the mark. Koshnitsky with an offensive rebound, but that's why he gained separation with a push. The officials are discussing. They want to head over to the scorer's table and confirm that it was indeed the seventh foul on Illinois Wesleyan. And since it was a control foul, it will place Deontay Foster at the free throw line. Foster, 84% from the line this year, second on the team. Zach Boyd leads the squad in that department. 1-1 situation for Foster, who hits. Junior out of Muskegon, Michigan, averaging 6.6 points a ball game. Elmhurst ranks second in the CCIW in free throw percentage at 73%. Foster's toss, just like the first. 9-point Elmhurst lead, 17-8. Almost a mirror image except the polar opposite of what happened in the women's matchup. Gonzalez attempted a jump stop, had it knocked away. Foster takes off. Foster scurries into the lane and clears out. Foster, Phipps, Robertson, Robinson, and Grubel, the five for Elmhurst. Gonzalez, Reed, Koshnitsky, Zimmer, and Musselman for Illinois Wesleyan. Zimmer and Victor Davis own two fouls for the Titans. Foster around a screen towards the basket, throws it up, no, but Grubel will sleep in for the rebound. Here's Phipps. Strong to the rack, short, and chasing down the board is Reed. 8:15 to play. Musselman from dead on connects on a three-pointer. It's the first triple of the game for Illinois Wesleyan. For Musselman, just his sixth attempt and his third make from the land of three this year. 8 minutes even. Phipps posting. Foster will bounce it to the post, and it's knocked away. Rudnicki returning for the Titans. Nick Sanford back for Elmhurst. 17-11, Elmhurst up six. They've led by as many as nine here in the first half. Zimmer slings it into the post. Gonzalez spotting up. Three-pointer is good. Illinois Wesleyan has hit consecutive threes. And the Titans are coming roaring back here at Elmhurst. They were 0-5 to start, but have hit two in a row to pull within three at 17-14. That's maybe the difference between an Illinois Wesleyan team and an Augustana team. The Titans can indeed score from the perimeter. Augustana looked very confused at points and trying to shoot from outside. Sanford backing his way in. Out to Robinson. Inside the arc from 18. In and out. Rebound out of bounds off of Sanford to Illinois Wesleyan. Zach Boyd will return. The Titans can tie it up with a three-pointer. Elmhurst has always been tough to beat here at R.A. Faginal Hall. This year, the Blue Jays are 5-3, 0-1 loss in conference. That was to Wheaton, 67-55, in a game that was really closer than the margin. Zimmer ties it up. That would be three consecutive three-pointers for Illinois Wesleyan. 17 aside with 6:35 remaining. Boyd working around the arc. Now it's Robinson picking up his dribble, skipping for Sanford. Shy of the lane to the corner for Foster. Three-pointer in and out. Foul on the rebound. Boyd with a push. First on Zach Boyd. Team foul number six and a full timeout for Elmhurst. Momentum turning. The Blue Jays were in front 17-8 since then. Three consecutive threes. Nine straight for Illinois Wesleyan and a timeout with 6:17 to play. 17 aside. This is Blue Jay TV. Remaining in the opening 20 minutes of play. Illinois Wesleyan has heated up. Three consecutive three-pointers have turned what was a nine-point deficit into a tie game, and the Titans have a chance to grab the lead for the first time. Fell behind 6-0, have never led. Here's Reed to the basket short, follows it up by tapping it out to Gonzalez. 20 to work with as Rudnicki drives to the basket. His hook shot won't go. Sanford underneath. So two opportunities for Illinois Wesleyan to take control. Neither was successful, and a foul on the Titans. Kevin Reed. First on Reed, Deontay Foster step into the stripe. Two shots upcoming. Elmer's 3 of 3 at the free throw line. Foster a perfect 2 of 2. First free throw for Foster is good. He'll have another. A two-time letter winner here at Elmhurst College. Started 11 ball games last year. Scored 4.7 points per contest. Foster ranked second on the team in assists a season ago with 42. He has 47 assists this year. Wet spot being mopped up in the lane. You know, that's one of the challenges of playing in the winter, especially when there's weather outside. It's wet. The proximity of the fans to the floor, very close. So a lot of times you'll end up with wet spots that need to be addressed. That case was just from some condensation on the floor in an area where there had been plenty of action earlier. Foster connects on both free throws. Elmhurst again with the lead, 19-17. 5:45 to play, first half. Sanford went for the steal. Robinson will help. And in the air, Zach Boyd was airborne on the head fake from Reed. Second foul charge to Zach Boyd. So the leading scorer for both Elmhurst and Illinois Wesleyan with two fouls here in the half. Both on the floor as well. Victor Davis with two for the Titans on the bench. Kevin Reed converts on the free throw. Reed just a 50% shooter. That ranks last amongst the Illinois Wesleyan regulars. 20 of 40. Wouldn't know he was a 50% shooter here. Money on both. Andrew Zimnick replaces Reed. Tied up at 19. Elliot Gonzalez, some light pressure on Deontay Foster as he'll bring it up the floor. Boyd right in front of Ron Rose. Now Robertson, who opened the scoring with a three-pointer here tonight. 13 to work with for Elmhurst. Sanford on the baseline. Cross court for Robertson. Save the possession into the lane with the shot clock at 3. Robinson turns around and his 8-footer rims out. The Titans are 0 for 2 in attempts to make the lead, and now they're 0 for 3. Wide open layup. Zimnick, I don't even think, realized how open he was. Had time to put it on the ground and even work his way closer. Instead, tried the floating 3-footer and didn't hit anything. We'll have a kick with 22 on the shot. Brandon Grubel back in for Elmhurst. 4:41 to play in this tie ball game. Tim Calderwood with you here on Blue Jay TV. Deontay Foster patient in the corner with a count on. Now we'll start to move. Out comes Robinson. Shot clock at 10. Zach Boyd directing traffic. Koshnitsky on Boyd. Boyd steps back off the mark from 23. Rebound out of bounds off of Rudnicki. Actually, he was able to hang on to it. Grubel tried to save it. Wouldn't have mattered anyhow. Titans are 0 for 3 on the attempts for the lead. That'll change here. Illinois Wesleyan in front for the first time tonight. Score it for Parker Musselman. Musselman, the freshman out of Bloomington. Hometown product, fourth-team All-State member, and a first-team Big 12 All-Conference choice as a senior. Averaged close to a double-double. Normal Community High School finished fourth in Illinois Class 4A. He'll cap off the three-point play. And Illinois Wesleyan owns a three-point lead, 22-19. And a turnover for Elmhurst. Illinois Wesleyan has just kind of stayed the course here in the half. Elmhurst now with nine turnovers. Both teams very good at valuing the basketball. Both under 14 turnovers a contest. Titans looking to build on the three-point edge. Musselman will screen for Koshnitsky. Koshnitsky looking to move. He'll drive. Flip to Musselman in the corner for three. Good. Six straight for the freshman Parker Musselman. And a six-point lead for Illinois Wesleyan, 25-19. The Titans travel well. There is a large contingency across the way, and they're making some noise now. Foster directing traffic. And a timeout for Elmhurst. Mark Shear has spent four timeouts in the first half. 25-19, Illinois Wesleyan in front as we step aside. 3:17 in front of the break. This is Blue Jay TV. Four three-pointers for Illinois Wesleyan, all in a row after the Titans missed on their first five. Illinois Wesleyan has built a six-point lead. Freshman Parker Musselman has connected on six straight. First a three-pointer play the old-fashioned way, and then a three-pointer from the corner. He scored the last six. Zach Boyd, bothered by Eric Dortch. And Boyd will head to the free throw line where he is one of one today. Zach Boyd, 86% free throw shooter on the season, 40 of 46. And he's looking for more here in the first half. Elmhurst led 17-8. A 9-0 run immediately tied the ball game thanks to three straight threes. They've been outscored 17-2. The closing moments of the half. Gonna have to check my math on that one. That's not right. 25-20. Boyd connects on both free throws. 25-21 with just over 3 minutes left in the first half. Musselman working on Dornfeld will sling it for Koshnitsky in the lane. Strong move off the back iron. Nick Sanford another rebound. Elmhurst does own a plus five margin on the glass here in the first half, 15-10. Rudnicki with his hands in the passing lane. Stepped out of bounds. Robertson working around the arc. Shot clock down to 7. Here's Foster faking right, moving left, throwing up outside the lane. No good. Musselman outlets to Rudnicki in transition for the 2. Well, it wasn't a basket for Musselman, but it was an assist. 6 points and an assist for the freshman have contributed to the last 8 Titan points. Back to a 6-point game at 27-21. Sanford driving baseline. Denied there by Zimnik. Throws it up towards the basket. Underneath Musselman rips away the board. Strong half for Musselman. That's why he's still on the floor for the Titans. Here's Zimnik backing his way in. Pivoting over the top of Sanford. Hook shot goes. Largest lead for Illinois Wesleyan, 29-21. Remember, this was 17-8 at one point in favor of Elmhurst. Robertson picks up his dribble. He'll leave this short J. Gonzalez with a no-look pass towards Zimnik. Double-digit lead with 1 minute to play in the half. ...31-21. All the momentum with the visitors. Out comes Boyd. And a blocking foul on Zimnik. That'll be his first. Other scores around the conference. Augustana is hosting Carthage. And North Central pouring it on in the second half down in Decatur. Up by 34 over Millikan, 59-25. Zach Boyd, 3 of 3 at the free throw line. That'll change, however, with a miss. Titans have weathered some foul problems here in the half and are up by double digits. Boyd looking to split the pair. Cannot. Musselman with another rebound. The shot clock has gone dark as Illinois Wesleyan will spend a 30-second timeout. I lied. There's a 2-second difference between the shot clock and game clock here. With Illinois Wesleyan up 10 in the first half, winding down here in Elmhurst. I'm Tim Calderwood with you here on Blue Jay TV. Elmhurst in the final home game for a while. They'll be on the road all of next week. Carthage in Kenosha on Tuesday. And then a date with North Park in Chicago as well. As we mentioned early on, the Blue Jays are in the thick of not only the CCIW tournament discussion, but also the CCIW championship race. But this is a pivotal matchup here tonight. They came out very strong. Roared to a 17-8 lead, but from that point on, it has been all Illinois Wesleyan. 23-4 run for the Titans, who are up by double digits and will basically hold for the final shot of the half. Gonzalez just continues to work on that dribble. Who says it's not the most important move in basketball? Shot clock down to 5. Here's Zimnik on the right side. Banks home the 3. Fifth three-pointer of the half for Illinois Wesleyan. But a quick foul as a mistake is made by the Titans after the fact. Elliot Gonzalez with his first foul. And it'll be Deontay Foster shooting free throws for the Blue Jays. First attempt is in. Foster, the team leader in assists, also leads the team in three-point percentage. Spinning the ball and converting. 11-point Illinois Wesleyan lead, 34-23. Gonzalez dribbles in. His 18-footer would have been good if it counted, but it's off the back iron, and we have reached the break. 34-23, Illinois Wesleyan finds themselves in front by 11. A strong close to the first half for the Titans. We'll have numbers, scores, and more coming your way in a bit. We are at the break in Elmhurst. Illinois Wesleyan, 34, Elmhurst, 23. This is Blue Jay TV. It is halftime here at R.A. Fagenal Hall. I'm Tim Calderwood with you on Blue Jay TV. Elmhurst trailing Illinois Wesleyan by 11 at the break, 34-23. Let's take a look at the first half numbers. Really a story of kind of two halves within a half. Elmhurst was off to a very strong start. The Blue Jays led 17-8 at one point, seemed to be in a position to potentially run away with the ball game, and then Illinois Wesleyan decided, hey, we need to start showing up here as well. The co-leaders of the CCIW came up with a strong finish. In fact, Illinois Wesleyan, after starting 0-5 from three-point range, hit five in a row. Got some very strong contributions from freshman Parker Musselman and much more. Elmhurst finished the half shooting only 27% from the field, 6 of 22. They were 2 of 5 from three-point range, 40%. Did visit the free throw line 11 times and were 9 of 11. Illinois Wesleyan, 12 of 26 in the half, 46%, 5 of 10 from three-point range, and 5 of 5 at the line. Elmhurst with 9 turnovers, Illinois Wesleyan 7. Total rebounds right now separated by only 1. 2 of the top rebounding teams in the conference. Elmhurst plus 1 right now, 15-14 over Illinois Wesleyan. Looking at some of the individual leaders for the Titans, leading the way presently, 9 points from Parker Musselman, the freshman, well above his season average. Andrew Zimnick with 7. Mind you, those two players are coming off of the bench. Jordan Zimmer, 2 quick fouls, sat for a majority of the first half. Victor Davis at about the midway point, well, he hit 2 fouls as well. So 9 for Musselman, 7 for Zimnick off the bench, and then 4 for Victor Davis and Kevin Reed, the leading scorers for Illinois Wesleyan. Elmhurst leading scorer, Deontay Foster with 9, Zach Boyd 7. Victor Davis opens the scoring in the second half. Jordan Zimmer, Elliot Gonzalez, John Kushnitsky, Victor Davis, and Kevin Reed as the 5 for the Titans, who are in the green. Illinois Wesleyan with a 13-point lead. That's the largest of the contest. Robinson tried to head towards the post, and it's knocked in amongst the cheerleaders. Jerome Robinson, James Robertson, Zach Boyd, Deontay Foster, and Nick Sanford. It's the starting 5 for Elmhurst to begin the second half as well. We'll see if they can start the half strong. They have to go all the way back to their own half with Deontay Foster. Shot clock at 10 as Foster races ahead. Boyd will push towards the corner. Running 16-footer, no good. Gonzalez airborne on the rebound, falls to the floor. So Elmhurst needs to tighten up in terms of turnovers here in the second half. Feel like they need to work a little more on the offensive end as well. Jerome Robinson quickly off the floor with 2 fouls. Eric Dornfeld will replace him. Look for more of an inside presence for Elmhurst here in the second half. Feel like the Blue Jays were at their best in the first when Elmhurst was playing zone. They switched it about the midway point to man. That was when the Titans started to go on the run. Tremendous close to the first half for Illinois Wesleyan. K Koshnitsky and Gonzalez playing catch. Here's Zimmer spotting up. Three-pointer is through. The scary thing about the double-digit lead for Illinois Wesleyan is that man, Jordan Zimmer, was non-existent in the opening 20. Primarily due to foul trouble. Titans can run away and hide if he heats up here in the second. Zimmer with 6 points. 16-point advantage for Illinois Wesleyan. Here's Foster, leading three-point shooter for Elmhurst, has two tonight. Foster with a dozen, leading all scorers in the contest. And he gets into the act defensively, partially tipping the pass. Here's Zimmer off the screen. Good again. Well, they're not making it easy for Zimmer, but he's hit back-to-back threes for Illinois Wesleyan. The key for Zimmer is to try and make him move. You do not want him coming off of a screen and having an open look. You want to make sure there's a hand on the face to contest, and if possible, you want him to have to put the ball on the ground. 15 on the shot for Elmhurst. Boyd surrounded, dribbles out, down to 10. Dornfeld backing in against Reed, off the window and in. First points of the evening for Eric Dornfeld. Quick entry pass towards Reed, who makes it look easy. 44-28. Well, Elmhurst definitely needs to find a way to get back onto the defensive end. We need to start to make things a little harder for Illinois Wesleyan as well. Titans have really heated up. Boyd on the baseline, short. Gonzalez on the move. Reed will set the screen for Koshnitsky, spinning, dumping back for Reed. Two more points for the Titans, who are up 18, 46, 28. Look out. Sanford puts it on the deck. Missed. Reed will bring in the rebound. It's been one and done on the offensive end for Elmhurst. Gonzalez, meanwhile, will lead a 3-on-2, and Davis slams it home. 20-point lead for Illinois Wesleyan. My goodness. ...14-5 run to open the second. Mark Scheer has only two timeouts at his disposal. He'll use one of those here with 16:07 to play. Illinois Wesleyan in command, 48-28. This is Blue Jay TV. Tim Calderwood with you on Blue Jay TV. 16:07 to play. Illinois Wesleyan rolling to start the second half, a 14-5 run. Elmhurst played very strong for the first 10 minutes of the ball game. Held a 9-point advantage at 17-8. Since then, as you can tell by the scoreboard, well, a 40-11 change. North Central opened the second half on a 25-0 run in Decatur against Milliken, cruising to a 74-37 win. Foster with five, scoops and scores. Augustana, meanwhile, was up double digits at home, 48-30. One possession at a time. That's the way to approach it. Zimnik will find Dortch in the corner. And a foul after Dortch unleashed the shot. Eric Dornfeld with his second foul. Fresh 35 for the Titans. Zimmer forced to drive. There's the Dortch in the corner working on Dornfeld. Throws it away. Good crowd on hand here at R.A. Fagenal Hall tonight. Foster with his head up, starts to move. Skips towards Dornfeld. One dribble, steps in, 17-footer off to the left. Board for Zimnik. The Titans have also responded on the glass, making sure that Elmhurst is one and done here to open the second. Zimnik scores and a foul. Jerome Robinson's third foul, third on Elmhurst as well. Zimnik, who recorded a big first half, trying to become the first Titan to reach double digits. And he does. 10 points for Zimnik, 9 for Zimmer, 9 for Parker Musselman as well. 51-30. Illinois Wesleyan continues to pad the lead here in the second half. Dornfeld moves towards the corner. Foster changing course. Tried to set a screen for Boyd. Boyd in the lane from 13. Nope. Fighting for the rebound. Boyd again initiates contact with Nick Anderson. And it'll be Zach Boyd's turn at the line. Seven points for Zach Boyd in the ball game. He is 3 of 5 from the free throw line. And the senior from Warrensburg, Illinois, the only four-year player on this Elmhurst College roster, is heading to the line here. Free throw is no good. Zach Boyd hit 8 free throws against North Park. His season high total, 24 points against Wash U. Third team all-CCIW choice a year ago. Slowly whittling away the deficit. Still a lot of basketball to be played here tonight. Elmhurst in the first half certainly showed all kinds of defensive flashes. Anderson found himself wide open in the post. He has it, twists around Dornfeld, and a layup. Back to a 21-point lead, 53-32. And a whistle. Eric Dornfeld a little frustrated away from the basketball as he tried to set a screen. Eric Dortch is whistled for his third foul. Robertson will roll out right side and hit. A couple of bodies falling to the floor in the blocks. Three-pointer for James Robertson, his second three. Koshnitsky will flip to Zimmer. Robertson on him defensively. Zimmer a big reason for the Illinois Wesleyan explosion here in the second half. Elmhurst tries to switch up defensively. Rudnicki skipping for Anderson, denied. Nick Sanford with a block. And it'll head out of bounds to Elmhurst. There hasn't been a lot for the Blue Jays to cheer about here in the second half. But that changed moments ago thanks to Nick Sanford. Perhaps little victories here and there can give the Blue Jays things to build upon. Perhaps can help them trim away the deficit. Foster around a screen, jump stop in the lane. May have been partially blocked by Anderson. It was short anyhow. Zimnik, here's a quick outlet towards Koshnitsky. And a push is called underneath the bucket. Three fresh ones coming in for Illinois Wesleyan, including Parker Musselman, who was one of the stories of the first half. Rudnicki to the post, no-look feed towards Musselman, who's on his way to the stripe. Reed drew the crowd and then flipped it to the wide-open Musselman. Musselman into double figures. 9 first-half points for Parker Musselman. Musselman with a season-high total now at 9 points, and a career-high at that matter. It's only the second CCIW game that he has appeared in. But he's certainly making the case for more PT here tonight. 54-35. Closing in on 12 minutes to go. Sanford from 19 connects. Gonzalez around a screen from Musselman. Now it's Rudnicki driving baseline. Musselman setting a screen, and there's an offensive foul. Moving screen on Musselman. His brother Jordan, a former Illinois Wesleyan football player. His other brother Tate, currently on the Illinois Wesleyan football squad. 54-37. This really becomes a big possession here for Elmhurst. Gonzalez put in the press on Grubel. Michael Jurkovic off the bench for Elmhurst, his first appearance tonight. Justin Phipps to the free throw line, jump stop, off the window, no. Nick Sanford, offensive rebound, his second chance isn't there. Sanford has a third one coming, blocked from behind, and Kevin Reed over the back was able to reach a peek across and collect a bit of the arm of Sanford as well. Free throws coming. Sanford at the free throw line and good. Sophomore out of Decatur, Illinois, home of Millikan University. Sanford just a 49% shooter from the free throw line this year, but he hits on both free throws. ...54-39 in Elmhurst, slowly chipping away. It was once a 21-point lead for Illinois Wesleyan. Here's Reed. Denied on this chance for Musselman in the post. And a shove from behind. Fouls beginning to climb here in the second half as well. We've yet to reach the midway point of this frame. Jerkovic with his first foul. That'll be the sixth on Elmhurst. Gonzalez inbounding. Reed is held up. Seventh foul on Elmhurst. One and one for Reed. Nope. And Sanford wrestling away the rebound. Sanford again. Showcasing some range here in the second half. And the crowd a little upset underneath. Justin Phipps whistled for his third foul. Jordan Zimmer with two for the Titans. He's the third Illinois Wesleyan player in double figures. Jordan Zimmer, third in the CCIW in scoring, a two-time conference player of the week. One of four seniors on this Illinois Wesleyan roster. Will again distance the lead to 15. Elmhurst with only one timeout in the pocket. That's why when they have issues inbound in the basketball, they really need to find a way to get it in. Phipps between the rings. He'll start to move. Around a screen and take it all the way. Who knew Phipps could drive? Converted football player. Here's Zimmer in the corner for three and good again. Timeout Illinois Wesleyan. Full timeout with 10:15 to play. Jordan Zimmer buries his fourth three of the ball game. 14 points for Zimmer. 59-43 Illinois Wesleyan in front as we step aside on Blue Jay TV. Wesleyan in control tonight at R.A. Fagenal Hall. I'm Tim Calderwood with you from Elmhurst College on Blue Jay TV. Elmhurst came out very strong to start the contest, but Illinois Wesleyan with a very solid run at the end of the first half. It carried over to begin the second. And the Blue Jays began ever so slowly to whittle away at the deficit. But Illinois Wesleyan has found a way to again stretch it to 16. Jordan Zimmer, one of the big reasons why. Zimmer with 14 points. Here is Sanford to the basket. Good again. We talked about a potential coming out party for Illinois Wesleyan's Parker Musselman, appearing in just his sixth ball game of the year. Well, how about Nick Sanford for Elmhurst? Sure, he's been strong all season long, but Sanford now with 8 points in the ball game to go along with seven rebounds. Double figures for Victor Davis joins the parade. Illinois Wesleyan with four players in double figures. 9:20 left, 16-point lead. Boyd lost the basketball, but he's fouled. Third foul on Kevin Reed. Phipps posting and calling over to Boyd, who finds himself on the left edge. Catch and shoot from 15. And again, it's Elmhurst within 14. Kuchnitsky bouncing to the block. Reed having issues. Reed dribbling, swatted away by Sanford, out of bounds off Davis. Defensive stop for Elmhurst. Deontay Foster in the middle of the NCAA logo. 8:35 to play. That's still a lot of time. Brandon Grubel skipping for Phipps. Back to Grubel. Spot up three-pointer. Bingo! 11-point game. 61-50. Here come the Blue Jays. Kuchnitsky skips for Davis, right around Phipps and scores. Sanford did his best to help, but it's now 63-50. Zach Boyd towards the corner in the triple threat. Phipps in the lane, backing up against Reed. Too strong off the glass. And as Illinois Wesleyan has been able to do all night so far, the Titans have responded. 7.5 to play. 13-point advantage at 63-50. Gonzalez out to Davis for three. Back iron. Rebound loose. Grubel brings it in. Seven minutes to play. Grubel looking for the block. Knocked away. Gonzalez off to the races. Boyd comes in to bother. And Zach Boyd will be charged with his third foul. Elliot Gonzalez shooting free throws for the Titans. One thing I'll say about Illinois Wesleyan, they utilize their junior varsity team. Gonzalez began his career as a JV player. He's earned three varsity letters at Illinois Wesleyan. Won a state championship in high school at Richards High School. 65% foul shooter, splits. 6:50 remaining. 14-point lead for the Titans. Robinson will set a screen for Grubel. Driving from 13, nope. Dortch with the board. Dortch looks left, looks right, comes back to the left for Gonzalez. Rudnicki pops out. In the lane, it's Dortch with a floating six-footer, no, and Grubel is there with the board. 6:05 to play. Robertson to the Grubel in the corner, but an offensive foul. Andrew Zimnick stepped in and drew the charge. Second foul on James Robertson. And the Titans again have the opportunity to tick off some clock. Dortch picked up the dribble. Back out to Gonzalez, shot clock at 10. The Titans can afford to run time. Gonzalez will drive and score.
Open up, guys, ref.
66-50, it's back to a 16-point advantage. Boyd, right of the lane, on his way to the stripe. Zach Boyd with 11 points in the ball game. It's the free throw. The only four-year player on the Elmhurst roster and one of only two seniors. Jerome Robinson, a one-year transplant this season, coming in from Lewis University. A little bit of a friendly roll. And here comes Parker Musselman for Illinois Wesleyan. The Titans, 13-3, ranked 17th in the D3Hoops.com Top 25 poll. It's been an interesting week in terms of nationally ranked teams yet again. Lots of ups and lots of downs. Illinois Wesleyan, no exception, losing on the road to North Central on Tuesday. Trying to come up with a road win here to make up for that defeat. Jordan Zimmer with a pretty move, shows he can drive as well. Titans are 6-3 away from the Shirk Center. Perfect 7-0 at home this year. Shirk Center is a tough place to play. These teams will meet again down at Illinois Wesleyan in the regular season finale, February 18th. Dornfeld off the back iron. Boyd will tap the rebound to Robinson, who stepped out of bounds. 4:33 to play. 16-point lead for the Titans, 68-52. Sanford and Phipps return for the Blue Jays. Rudnicki, long three-pointer. Front iron, rebound is free. Brought in by Phipps, 3-on-2. Foster turns it on to the basket, yes. Deontay Foster in transition. Leading scorer for Elmhurst with 16 points here tonight. In the lane, Musselman. And one. My goodness. The coming out party for Parker Musselman continues here in Elmhurst. Musselman with 12 and looking for more. Will exit with 13 points, a career high for the freshman. Less than 4 minutes to go. Illinois Wesleyan up 17, 71-54. Sanford picks up his dribble. Tapped away. Zach Boyd tried to save the possession. Out of bounds off the Titans. 17 to work with for Elmhurst. Blue Jays have a tough week ahead. Couple of road contests. Big one in Kenosha against Carthage. And then the second go-round begins 1 week from tonight at North Park in a 7 o'clock affair. Sanford in the lane, turning around from 10. Good. Timeout, Elmhurst. Final timeout for Mark Scheer and the Blue Jays with 3:29 to play. Elmhurst is down 15 at 71-56. Mentioned that the Blue Jays are on the road all of next week. Your next chance to catch Elmhurst in action will be January 31st, right here on Blue Jay TV. It'll be a doubleheader between the men and the women against North Central College, one of the area foes from here in DuPage County. So glad to have you alongside. Elmhurst came out strong, looking to build upon consecutive victories, trying to post three straight wins in the CCIW for the first time since 2008-2009. Elmhurst, in that year, reached the NCAA tournament, lost in the conference championship game to Wheaton, won seven in a row in conference play at 1 point. But so far tonight, it has been Illinois Wesleyan in control. The Titans tied atop the CCIW standings, looking to stay that way as both North Central and Wheaton have recorded victories this evening. North Central manhandling Milliken in Decatur, Wheaton with a rather easy road victory at North Park. One other game presently going on, Augustana and Carthage. And Augie was up 20-plus in that contest as well. The Vikings looking to rebound after a rough start. Can't reach 3-3 in the CCIW. They had lost three in a row entering this week. 15-point game, 71-56. Titans break the huddle with Reed, Zimmer, Zimnik, Koshnitsky, and Gonzalez. The ball is in the hands of Gonzalez. We'll skip it out high to Reed. Gonzalez above his head, bouncing for Zimnik, backing his way in. Zimmer forced to drive, skips for Zimnik underneath, swatted away by Sanford. Zimnik gets it back, and a second chance basket for Andrew Zimnik. Zimnik off the bench having a huge day. 12 points now for the Titans. 73-56. Elmhurst with Phipps, Sanford, Boyd, Foster, and Robertson. Foster in the corner. Phipps wants the basketball badly. Robertson behind the back. Shot clock at 10. Boyd double team. Phipps will set the screen. Boyd off the screen. Rolling left. Three-pointer. Nope. Koshnitsky with the board. Illinois Wesleyan started out the game tonight shooting about 20%. They've turned on the jets since. Gonzalez, a nice bounce pass towards Zimnik and a whistle as Andrew Zimnik, the sophomore from Oswego, will head to the line. This Illinois Wesleyan team lost a lot from last year. Defeated Elmhurst twice a season ago, 75-55 in Bloomington and 72-68 here in Elmhurst. Long on the attempt from Zimnik. Be quite honest with you, they've been one of the surprise stories thus far in the CCIW, though. Atop the conference, along with Wheaton and North Central. 2:11 to play. 18-point lead, 74-56. Blue Jays trying to pick up the pieces, builds the momentum, heading into the matchup at Carthage on Tuesday. Inside of 2 minutes. Boyd for three. Front iron. Followed his shot, though. Lost the basketball. It's on the floor. And Jordan Zimmer heading for free throws. Elmhurst also started out incredibly strong on the glass. They've had problems from about the midway point of the first half on. Free throw good from Zimmer. Elmer still out rebounding Illinois Wesleyan 27-24 in the matchup. Jordan Zimmer above his season average with 17 points. Majority of those have come here in the second half. Make it 18 and he'll exit. Off the bench comes Daniel Oswald. Nice round of applause from the Illinois Wesleyan faithful. As Zimmer will leave with 1:45 remaining in Illinois Wesleyan back in front by 20. Sanford spinning, no good. Dornfeld underneath. They're heading to the line. Dornfeld heading for free throws. Victor Davis with his third personal. 2 of those fouls for Davis came in the first half. That's been the other difference really for Illinois Wesleyan. They were plagued by foul problems early. Weathered the storm, found themselves up 11 at halftime. Ron Rose clearing the bench. Dylan Overstreet. Michael Mayberger. Brandon Hyen. All on the hardwood, along with David Molinari, who is returning to action for Illinois Wesleyan today. And an over-the-back call on the rebound, charge to Jerkovich. Second foul on Jerkovich. Free throws here for Brandon Hyen. Back iron. Hyen, a freshman out of Paxton, Illinois. This is just his second appearance of the year. Lettered in track in high school. And he has his first points. Brandon Hyen, the 6'7 freshman, with the first points of his collegiate career. 77-57 with 1:20 to go. Foster for three. Foster with 19 points. He's continued to emerge for Elmhurst as his season and career progress. Molinari with a shot fake, throws it away. .102 left. Foster collects. Final minute of play. Jerkovich to Dornfeld, around the arc we go. Krubel will attempt the three-pointer, well short. Rebound in the belly of Overstreet. And the freshman will ease it across half court to the right side. Oswald's three-pointer, no. Offensive rebound. The Titans spread the floor. Here's a three in the corner from Hyen. Nope. Foster controls. Shot clock is off. Foster looked for Grubel, threw it away. Overstreet will outlet towards Mayberger, and instead of going strong to the rack, Mayberger will clear it out, and Illinois Wesleyan will milk the final 13 seconds. The Titans are going to improve to 14-3 on the year. They will maintain hold of first in the CCIW, sitting 5-1, tied with Wheaton and North Central. Illinois Wesleyan now 5-1, as we mentioned, and 14-3 overall. Elmhurst drops to 3-3. The Blue Jays will pull even with Augustana in the battle for that fourth slot presently. Carthage, meanwhile, will drop to 2-4. Elmhurst will meet Carthage in a pivotal contest on Tuesday. Put the finishing touches on our broadcast here tonight on Blue Jay TV. I'm Tim Calderwood. Glad you took some time out of your Saturday to join us. For this doubleheader, Illinois Wesleyan sweeping both the women and the men victorious, and in both cases solidifying their holds on first place in the conference. On the women's side of things, Illinois Wesleyan's victory handed them first place all by themselves, dropping Elmhurst for the first time in conference play this year. Here on the men's side, the final score provides Illinois Wesleyan with a continual tie atop the standings with Wheaton and North Central. Let's take a look at the final stats in this one before we get up out of here. Elmhurst for the ball game shoots 38%, 19 of 50. Illinois Wesleyan 55%, from the floor. Jordan Zimmer finishes with 18 to lead the Titans. Deontay Foster, 19 to lead Elmhurst. The Blue Jays drop to 9-8 on the year and 3-3 in the CCIW. A couple of road contests coming up next week. The Blue Jays will head to Kenosha on Tuesday to meet Carthage, and then they'll be in Chicago to meet North Park on Saturday. So road contests are always important when it comes to the CCIW landscape. The Blue Jays will spend next week on the road before returning home January 31st to meet North Central. That'll put the finishing touches on our broadcast tonight. For our entire crew here on Blue Jay TV, producer-director Glenn and cameraman Phil, I'm Tim Calderwood. Thanks for watching.